No, there are no rest.
No.
Oh, okay, it's okay. Yeah, I will do that. Sorry.
Again.
Yeah, okay. Actually, I changed my titles because previously my title of this topic is using JNA in closure, but I changed the title to entropy with the C in closure. So if you have any question to me or something, a question to later after finishing this presentation, so we can save each other's time. Actually, I wanted to receive the question from the Slack, but there are no Wi-Fi, so it is okay to the using the speak. Yeah, that is my simply my profile. So until now, I'm working as a game client programmer, and I'm from Korea, and now working in Singapore in a private company. So I want to share my experience. At first, I wanted to trying to using the SDL library via Clojure. There are no SDL library in Clojure, so I wanted to make my own library to using SDL. So I made some example of the C binding in Clojure, and I wanted to share my approach and my experience to you. So there are some problem of this. If you want to using the C library in the Clojure, you have three major problems. One is how to load the library, shared library, or state library. And one is how to write in the wrapper class. And one is how to write in the C layout for accessing the native address. So as you see, there are many kind of library. One is JNI. And JNA. Maybe you heard about JNI or JNA too. And the third thing is JNR. And next thing is Java CPP. And last one is Panama. It's a new feature, so it's still developing. But Panama will be shipped on the JDK future in the future. But I prepared first three examples, not less two things, because I don't have enough time to research about this, so I just introduced, and there are no example for last two things. So first thing is JNI. JNI is shipped from the JDK 1.1, it's very old things. So if you want to using the JNI for using the C library, you need to, of course, you need to prepare the C library. And you need to write in the Java class for accessing the C library. And after that, you generated a C header from that Java file. And from that, you need to write in the C code, some code, for load the C library. Calling the C library, and after that, you can start to write in your Clojure library. So I will show some example for you. Oops. Well, it doesn't seem. Okay. So, wait. Yeah. At first, you need the FreePLC library, and second thing is a compile Java caller and generate into OP header and compile into OP library, and finally you can write in the Clojure project. Oops. So this is a very simple function, just the A plus B. So the first thing you need to compile the C library. As you see, there are it produced the hello.dll. It's a shared library in Windows system. In Linux system, it will be a live hello.so. So you just generate the C library from this source. And after that, what's the next is before that, you need to the class for color-native hello. You need to write in the JIT Java class for calling, loading the hello library. Java. Right, correct. So next thing is using this Java file, once you need to compile to Java using the Java C. So as you see, you can check the compiled the JNI hello dot class file. And after that, you need to the generate the entropy header from that class. As you see, you can check the header file from that class. And after that, you need to write this function for calling the native library. Finally, you got an entropy C library for this. Actually, Java using the this DLL, not hello.dll directly. So JNI is using the hello underscore JNI.dll using that, that C library. And via that library, Java calling the real C library. So finally, because we are a Clojure programmer, so let me check the Clojure library. Clojure part is very simple because it's just calling the previous because we already have a JNI hello class. So Clojure just using the that function, what we predefined. So using the native hello library, and second what we need is previously we compiled the new hello underscore JNI library. Because of this previous Java source loading the hello underscore JNA, not just hello, because Java cannot calling the JNI cannot calling the directly to using the hello. JNI need to the compile to another library for calling the C library. So we compile the hello underscore JNI. So as you see, we check the result of that. Clojure source is here. Just 10 plus 20. So we check the right result. As you see, mature JNI program is a very long step. It's a six step of that for just using the C library. Because of that, JNA occurred. JNA is very simple than JNI, but much slower than JNI. JNI example is very simple. Just using the, just prepare the C library that previously is hello.dll. And just from that, just writing the Cloud code, it will be work. As you see, compared to JNI, JNI's library is very simple things. Because of in the JNA, you need to the prepare 6 steps. So you need the C library, and Clojure project, and Java Entropy project, and Java Native project. But in JNA, you just prepare the C library, and just prepare the Clojure library. C file doesn't. C file is the same as previous. The different part of the definition of the Clojure part. Compared to the JNI. In the JNI, we need to prepare the Java file for interop. But in JNA, you don't need to prepare the Java file for interop. You just writing the interface, which extended from the JNA library. And you define the method. Yeah, just synchronize the type of this int, and this is argument, and this is a return type. And after that, you load the library, and just writing the wrapper function, and just using that function. So now you can check the same result over there. Compared to JNI, JNI is much simpler than. And there are some other library for interop. That's your JNR. So compared to JNA, step is very same thing. So I'll just showing just compared to the Clojure file itself. So this is the JNA. Okay, right side is your JNA, but we saw the previous. And left side is your J and R. The difference of this, J and R need to the extend the JNA library need to the extend the JNA dot library. But on the JNR, you don't need to the extend the any library, just using the interface itself. And performance also is JNR much better than JNA. JNA is worst performance, and JNI is your best has your best performance. But JNR is between JNA and JNI. But as you see, there are some problems of the JNA, JNR, JNA. One thing is you need to write the let part function for that. Java or Clojure, you need to write the let part function for that. To solving this problem, there are two projects. What I didn't handle that. One is your Java CPP. Nowadays, there are some most popular C library, for example, OpenCV or some things. But on Java side, you want to do using the C library calling because you want to do using the OpenCV or some things. But in JNI and other from the J, you need to do writing by the hand to wrapper function for that. But this project provides the auto generated interface, so you can more easily maintain the entropy library. But I didn't prepare this example, so I just prepared the link. But now internet doesn't work well, so I will skip this part. And another thing is Panama. Actually, Panama, in my memory, Panama will be shipped to JDK 10 or 11, or I'm not sure, but Oracle just prepared this library for interop. This library also contains the code generate, and yes, yeah. I just linked that, so if you interesting about this project, follow this link. And back to first, because I wanted to writing the HDL library for Clojure. Before explain what I did, what is HDL? HDL is a simple direct media layer. So for game programmer, it's very familiar library to make a game because this API is very simple and it is easy to read the code. So there are many languages support that binding, C# or some things. Of course, Java also has support that binding, but this project was dead. This project doesn't maintain well. So I'm starting the writing the HDL a library, so I wanted to share what I did. On this project, I'm using the JNA. So I import the JNA, a native and pointer. And I'm writing the interface using the JN interface and extend the JNA library. So I'm writing the some function like this. And this is the main function. So as you see, I calling the SDLC library directly using the JNA. So you can see the result of this. As you see, I wrote some logic to receive the key event. So when I moving the key, so you can check the logo for that. I starting to the developing this library because I feel got tired to writing the referral function manually. So yeah, that's the problem of the JNA and JNI, JNR. So next what I will do, I want to try the Java CPP or Panama for future. So I just stopped at first, but now I just wanted to share what I did and what's the problem, what I got. And I just wanted to share the how to using C library in the Java world to you. And is there any question to me or no?
Can you use other native languages besides C?
Pardon?
Other languages like Rust, or do you use any other language besides C?
If you follow the rule for dynamic language, dynamic library, yeah, so you can call in the library, yeah. You can compile or share the library using the Rust or some other languages. So, okay. So I'll close my presentation.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.